Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, in today's video, we are going to see what do you mean by current source, what is typical current source, what are the advantage and disadvantage of the circuit. So let's begin with the topic. Now, there are various biasing circuits that we know. And the various biasing circuits are voltage divider bias, base bias, self bias. These biasing circuits are basically used for biasing of BJT and FET. And the circuits are required to be discrete one. But when we talk about the integrated circuit, then we cannot use these biasing circuit because the integrated circuit requires fabrication on the chip. The biasing circuit uses large number of resistors and capacitors. In case of resistor, the fabrication of resistor on a chip requires large surface area as compared to transistor. Therefore, it is difficult to provide such large surface area on chip. Second reason is the values of capacitor. The bypass and coupling capacitor which are used in the biasing circuit are in the range of microfarad. Therefore, large values of capacitors are required and fabrication of these values of capacitor on the chip also requires a large area and it is very much difficult to fabricate on the chip. Therefore, the integrated circuit uses different method of biasing than the discrete circuit. The integrated circuit uses constant current method for biasing of the circuit. Now let's have a look of typical current source. Basically, the current source is considered as one of the component of the circuit and the current source consists of positive node. Now, if we look at the typical current source, then we will come to know that the gate terminal is connected to the constant voltage, that is VGG, and the graph shows variation of output and input current and voltage. Now here we can say that this circuit will provide the output only when it satisfies the condition, that is Vout should be less than VGG plus VTO and the output resistance is given by 1 plus lambda VDS upon lambda into ID. The circuit having advantage as well as disadvantage. One of the advantage of the circuit is that it is simple to design and therefore it is very much easy to fabricate it on the chip as it requires less area. The disadvantage point of view of the circuit is that it provides small output resistance because of which it is not possible to obtain the constant current at the output. Second disadvantage of the circuit is that the value of V minimum is large and because of which the value of output voltage is get reduces. So this is what about the advantages and disadvantages of the circuit. The only advantage of the circuit is that it is very simple to build and easy to fabricate. But if we look at the disadvantage point of view, the circuit provides two main disadvantages, that is the output current is not constant and it also reduces the range of output voltage. This disadvantage can be removed by using various remedies. So in order to improve the performance of the circuit, the various other circuits are required to be used along with the typical current source. So this is what about introduction of current source and its advantage and disadvantage. So I hope you understand the topic of introduction of current source. So thank you very much for watching this video. Stay tuned to Ekeeda. Subscribe Ekeeda. Thank you.